I know him well, this hobo voice. He's always here with me, debating with my conscience and yearning to be free. But I continue to resist him with all the strength I know, and most of the time I do just fine till I hear that whistle blow. And he senses that he's winning and he's gonna have his way. And I stand my ground till the freight train sound carries me away. Then I get lost in yesterday when my world was young and new, and the memories flood and it killed my blood. If it's what I want to do. Well, the traffic arm is raised again, and the train has passed on by, and I'm still at the crossing with a long look in my eye. And my friend, the inner hobo, is fully wide awake, and I sense that he is gloating, and he's just about to make one more plea for freedom. He knows my heart's in pain as I stare down the main line at the rumbling, fading train. There's a lantern red and winking, and it hangs on the caboose. And it's calling, softly calling me to turn my spirit loose. How long can I resist the call? I really couldn't say. But the inner hobo's argument gets stronger every day. Now, I'm not one for idle talk, but I want the world to know that if I hear that whistle one more time, I just might up and go.
Just the adventure of it is all it was. You'd get on a train and go to a different area, or just to get away and do something different. It was just the adventure of it. That's all it amounted to.
For my wife.
Faded blue jeans and shirt and old pair of shoes. A slouchy old hat that I bought in a second-hand store. I don't need a backpack, this tattered old tow sack will do. That's all I need, I can't think of anything more. So, lady, don't cry, you'll never tie strings on this old boat. Lady, don't try, you'll never tie strings on this old boat. I'll stay for a while, but the good time's over when I hear a train whistle blow. Lady, don't try, you'll never tie strings on this old boat. You'll never hold this old ramblin' rover when my heart tells me it's time. Go. one morning, I slipped through your arms. Lady, don't try, you'll never tie strings on this hobo. I'll stay for a while, but the good time's over. And I hear a train whistle blow. Lady, don't try, you'll never tie strings on this hobo.
They seem, they're cruel places who laugh at your dream and watch for my comrades by the side of the track. And I know that there's some who pray we'll never come back. I'll seek out my comrades, Whitey with his guitar, Captain Dingo who can still see the stars, and I'll help Iowa Blackie lighten his pack, and with Buzz Potter we'll find strength along life's track. Beware of the cities, they're not what they seem. They're cruel places who laugh at your dream. And watch for my comrades by the side of the track. I know there are some who pray we'll never come back. Big
Said to him, you know, it's about time that they put a working person's picture on a postage stamp. And he said to me, do you know who that is? And I said, sure, that's A. Philip Randolph. He was the president of the sleeping car porters union. And so the postal clerk thanked me, you know, and he said, people have been asking me who that was, and now I can tell them. But sleeping car porters are gone, and the Pullman cars are gone, and A. Philip Randolph is gone, and the caboose is gone, like lots of things on the railroad. The railroad learned that they can get rid of three more people if they take the caboose off the end of the train, and as soon as they can figure out how to run that little feller without an engineer, they're going to do that too. So what they have in place of the caboose is a computer that clamps into the coupler of the last car. Sometimes they hold it on there with bungee cord wrapped around it. It has a red light on it that blinks on and off. It monitors the air pressure, and it keeps the engineer informed of his air pressure through a readout up in the cab. And they use scanners too along tracks. The scanners have the abilities to detect dragging equipment or a hot axle, and if the scanner sees anything wrong, it will radio that computer, and then the computer will begin to shut the train down. And the railroads, in their infinite wisdom, have poetically named these things the end of train device. I played this tune for an old timer. He worked for the Santa Fe Railroad. He said, you know, on the Santa Fe, we call them Freds. And I did not know what that was an acronym for, but it had something to do with rear end device. And I know a Union Pacific engineer who tells me that once in a while that bungee is not up to the job. And Fred will fall off, and it smashes, of course, when it hits the roadbed, and the train stops, and so they all run back there. Oh, Fred, get up, Fred. Oh, Fred, speak to us. No, but Fred don't get up, and Fred don't speak. So one day they were going over a trestle, and Fred rattled off, and it fell down into the water, and it's floating away, and the red light is still flashing on and off. Swim, Fred, swim! Tells me that sometimes people shoot at Fred. And I believe that. He's not paying any union dues. But since I've been singing this song, I've been collecting Fred stories because they seem to come rolling in, you know, these Fred stories. And if you got one that I have not heard, I'll buy you a pork chop for it. The latest one I got from Cuddy, who wrote and told me that a freight train without a caboose on it reminds you of those gowns they give you in the hospital. Missing from the modern ways. These will never be the good old days. You can hardly find a smiling face on an end of train device. I'd like to take my little grandson down to where a young boy's dreams were found. Couldn't show him an aero man's around an end of train device. Nothing's colder than an empty jug or the ring down in a coffee mug. Like a heart that don't return your love, an end of train device. Like a bar room after closing time or a hobo down to his last dime. Nothing's colder than the dollar sign or the end of train device. Caboose was made to see the end. You're gonna miss it like a longtime friend. You'll never wave at any railroad man on an end of train device. I'd like to take my little grandson down to where a young boy's dreams were found. Couldn't show him any romance around an end of train device. Nothing's colder than an empty jug or the ring down in a coffee mug. Like a heart that don't return your love, an end of train device. Like a bar room after closing time or a hobo down to his last dime. Nothing's colder than the dollar sign or the end of train device. My Union Pacific engineer friend, he wrote to me and he said, you know, I'd like to sing that song, but I don't have any grandkids yet and I sure can't sing that verse. And would you mind very much if we wrote a verse that we can sing out here in Omaha? And I said, well, be my guest. The lonesome whistle in the distance wails for automation and the welded rails. No one's making union scale on an end of train device. Like a bar room after closing time or a hobo down to his last dime. Nothing's colder than the dollar sign or the end of train device.
Thank you. and give a great hearty welcome to the King of the Hobos, Mr. Luther the Jet.
You don't have to stand or anything like that. I want to read from you one of the oldest poems. This is a song of the open road. I'm not going to read it all. Walt Whitman wrote it in early 1850s and published it in 1856 in the first edition of Leaves of Grass. And everybody has read this poem one time or another. Justice William O. Douglas cited it in a Supreme Court decision one time about the right to wander on the road, you know, things like that. So I'm going to read you a little bit of it. Sit still. Afoot and light-hearted, I take to the open road, healthy, free, the world before me, the long brown path before me leading wherever I choose. Henceforth I ask not good fortune, I myself am good fortune. Henceforth I whimper no more, postpone no more, need nothing, done with indoor complaints, libraries, querulous criticisms. Strong and content, I travel the open road. Oh, public road, I say I am not afraid to leave you, yet I love you. You express me better than I can express myself. You shall be to me more than my poem. From this hour, I ordain myself freed of limits and imaginary lines, going where I list, my own master, total and absolute, listening to others, considering well what they say, pausing, searching, receiving, contemplating gently but with undeniable will, divesting myself of the holes that would hold me, I inhale great drafts of space. The east and the west are mine. The north and the south are mine. Now, if a thousand perfect men were to appear, it would not amaze me. Now, if a thousand beautiful forms of women appeared, it would not astonish me. Now I see the secret of the making of the best persons. It is to grow in the open air and to eat and to sleep with the earth. Listen, I will be honest with you. I do not offer the old smooth prizes, but rough, new prizes. These are the days that shall happen to you. You shall not heap up what is called riches. You shall scatter with lavish hand all that you earn or achieve. Let's go after the great companions and to belong to them. They too are on the road. They are the swift and majestic men. They are the greatest of women, enjoyers of calms of seas and storms of seas, sailors of many a ship, walkers of many a mile of land, trusters of men and women, observers of cities, solitary toilers, pausers and contemplators of tufts, blossoms, shells of the shore, dancers at wedding dances, observers of cities, solitary toilers, pausers and contemplators, dancers, children, bearers of children, soldiers of revolts, standers by gaping graves, lowerers down of coffins, journeyers over consecutive seasons, over the years, the curious years, each emerging from that which preceded it, journeyers as with companions, namely their own diverse phases, fourth steppers from the latent, unrealized baby days, journeyers daily with their own youth, journeyers with their bearded and well-grained manhood, journeyers with their womanhood, ample, unsurpassed, content, journeyers with their own sublime old age, calm, expanded, broad, with the haughty breadth of the universe, old age flowing free with the delicious nearby freedom of death. Let's go to that which is endless as it was beginningless, to know the universe itself as a road, as many roads, as roads for traveling mountain. Oh, the big rock candy mountain, where the cops have wooden legs, and the bulldogs all have rubber teeth, and the hens lay soft four legs, where the farmer's trees are full of fruit, and the barns are full of hay, and I'm bound to go where there ain't no snow, and the rain don't fall, and the wind don't blow, in the big rock candy mountain. Oh, the big rock candy mountain, there's a land so fair and bright, where the boxcars all are empty and you sleep out every night, where the handouts grow on bushes and the sun shines every day on the birds and the bees and the cigarette trees and the lemonade springs where the bluebird sings in the big rock candy mountain. Oh, the big rock candy mountain, where you never change your socks and the little streams of alcohol go trickling down the rocks. There ain't no short-handled shovels, no axes, picks, or spades, and I'm bound to stay where they sleep all day, where they kill the Turk that invented work in the big rock candy mountain. Oh, the Big Rock Candy Mountain, where the jails are made of tin, and you can walk right out again just as soon as you go in. There the railroad bulls have all gone blind, and the shacks all tip their hats. There's a lake of stew and a gin lake too. You can paddle all around them in a big canoe in the Big Rock Candy Mountain.
With the group, every gathering you run into different fellows that come in from that part of the country. If you're in, say, Mississippi, you get the ones out of Alabama and Tennessee and around that area. So every gathering you don't see everybody congregate. It's different ones at each gathering. And it's just like a reunion all year long. They're family. They're just like part of your extended family, and they greet you like your long-lost relative. But it's just the love that we have for each other and the way of life, and we try to keep the memory of the hobo in existence yet, because over the years, the old-time hobo has vanished. Every year, we make new stones for the cemetery out to Britt, because we've lost another member of another member of our community, and it's sad. I just wish that I could have started years before and got to know some of the ones that had passed on before I started going to the convention.
Thank you.
It wouldn't be quite proper if we didn't, if somebody didn't do at least one U Utah Phillips song. And most of you don't know who U Utah Phillips, the golden voice of the Great Southwest, is. Well, shame on you. Now, he's one of the finest of our trade. Fine man, great songwriter, and a man who with two words taught me compassion. Taught me a real strong lesson. We were standing on a street corner in Spokane, Washington, and there was a fella walking across the street, and it was obviously he was pretty ruined by life's travails. He probably looked like somebody that might have got a little too much sterno. He was a good old poor, miserable wretch of a fellow, and he was walking across the street, and the light changed, and he was moving real slow, and he was crippled up. And people at the light, waiting for the light to change, got impatient, started honking their horns at him. And he froze. He just locked. He just stood there shaking. And he wet his pants. And it was really sad. And I looked at that guy and I said, "You pathetic one. Jesus, that's sick." And Utah just said, softly under his breath, said, "Poor fellow." And that struck me harder than a baseball bat in the back of the head. It was just such a thing. And since then, I sort of looked at people like that a little differently. This is sort of for those lost souls that we have out there. They sort of wander around. We've all seen them. And we should help them along the way. He comes like winds, like rainy gold, wasting no one's time or tears. He bears the pain and takes the blow. As he walks out his lonely years, though the wealthy share the spoil, good times seem to pass him by. They say he is too old to toil, yet he's still too young to die. Well, the road winds into the night. He lifts his pendle and moves on, brave against the failing light. His small form dwindles and is gone. He may pass this way again, maybe not, for nobody knows. It doesn't matter where or when. He comes like wind, like rain he goes. It doesn't matter where or when. He comes like wind, like rain.
One guy's little story about one of his adventures. If you listen to the words, you can notice that his life on the road starts out in the first verse is depicted as a life of pain, and by the time it's done, it's a life of contentment and pleasure. So I guess that's part of the lesson.
Thank you. kindness and ask for something to eat. A little piece of cornbread and a little piece of meat. She took me to her kitchen, oh man, she treated me nice and fine. Happy out of the notion, like the high-toned people do. But the very next train comes down at night, I bid that girl adieu. Yeah, I left her in the kitchen. Well, I pulled my cap down over my eyes and I walked down to the railroad track. And I lived on the next freight train and I never did complain. My heart began to flutter, yes, man, I began to sing. 10,000 miles away from home, I was bumming a railroad train, boy. Yes, I was bumming a railroad train.
Knew a man, Bojangles, and he danced for you. He'd worn out shoes, silver hair and ragged shirt and baggy pants. The oils of shoes. He jumped so high. He said his name Bojangles and he danced a lick across the cell. He grabbed his pants, oh, in feathered stance, for he jumped so high that he'd spit and he'd whirl. He let go a laugh, he let go another laugh. Shook back his clothes all around. Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, please dance. He danced at those old minstrel shows and county fairs throughout the South. Talk through tears how for 15 years his old dog and him traveled a his old dog up and he died. After 20 years he still grieves. Now he dances at every chance and throws a honky tonk for drinks and tips. But most of the time he's fed behind these old county bars, 'cause he drinks a bit. He shook his head, and as he shook his poor old lonely head, I heard someone ask him, please, Mr. Bojangles, please won't you please, Mr. Bojangles, please won't you please, Mr. Bojangles, please dance, won't you please dance. Come on now, dance. Won't you please
the world go around, whether we want to believe it or not. It's true. And when you're a little bit Lincoln, he can park your car. Washington, he can't take you too far. Well, Jefferson is good when you're at the track. If you want to bring some of that big money back, we're talking about dead presidents. Ain't one of them dead presidents. $20 Jackson, he can ease your mind. Yes, and if you're talking about the poor man's friend, a friend will get you out of whatever you're in. We're talking about dead presidents. Okay. You're gonna be the dead president. You know that I ain't broken, but I'm better than dead. Everybody loves dead presidents.
But I ain't got no cramps. At least my picture ain't great.
raised on old 32 cent stamp. I might be broke, but I'm better than dead. Everybody loves a dead president. Thank you very much, folks.
Just standing there.
son to Jack Delaney, who was a good hobo.
Yeah.
The Korean War veteran. It's called Dumpster Diving. Once in a while, he'd hit McDonald's and Kentucky Fried Chicken and the rest of them too to make sure his kitty cats got it. Keep rocking, though. You guys want to tap your foot? More than welcome to it. You ready? This is my brother's shoestring up here. I tagged a name on him. We went fishing the other night. And I wasn't sure or not, you know, because I just got in. I've been hard riding, and I got a ride the last couple few miles in with Songbird. You know, it looked like he had fishing flies or something touched him, you know, in his shoes and everything, so I just call him shoe flies. Yeah, hope he doesn't mind. Let's go play in the trash. While it's under glass, getting through the garbage, you'll have no cash. A little dinner out of common flash, won't you hold them pickles? Oh, got a medicine, special order, they don't upset us. Just as long as they would let us dive our way. You see, I live in the alley in a cardboard box. I do the breakfast with shots on the rocks. I'm in the trash, my kitty cats holding my socks. We'll do the waterfront, the dumpster dive, the docks. You got a hold of pickles, hold that pickles. Special odors, no one upset us. Just as long as they would let us dive in our way. Yeah, I wanna go dumpster diving. I'm surviving my kitty cats on a private day. Here's open a bit, have a little look. All prepared, there's no need to cook. We're on dumpster diving, oh, oh, oh. Don't you get away, kitty cat, I saw the first, it's mine. Garbage truck, keep the cats and I live down in our luck. Gonna take our food and all of our stash. Lick up the crumbs from the seats of your dash. Well, there's wrecks and loopies and there's jewels to pay. Cut the fried chicken and McDonald's on the way. There's a brand new game we can play. Hey, what's an old airborne's deli bag today? You gotta hold that pickles, hold that lettuce. Special orders don't want upset us. Just as long as they would let us dive in our way. Go, Shorty. Doggone it, cat. I told you you could have the tuna sandwich, the egg salad. I don't care. The aluminum cans and the bicycle parts belong to me. Today.
There you go.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Like me, an old hobo spirit
living inside is longing to hop a train and ride. Every night I close my eyes, I see a big black engine smoking up the sky. Hear those iron wheels turning, that lonesome whistle scream, as I ride once again in my dream. I see myself riding down the line, riding the rocks or hiding in the vines. That old hobo spirit living within is longing to hop a train again. When I close my eyes, I can see that lonesome old hobo, he looks a lot like me. Like that old hobo's parents,